you're going to love this segment, because one of the best parts of my job is meeting the students on our campus. And today we have two very special ones. Junior Lissade, who is from the country of Haiti and who came to America when you were 17 years old.
Right.
Tell us how you found out about Ave Maria University.
Well, my dad was working with a university, with a Catholic university back in Haiti, and he wanted to have an exchange program with Ave Maria University because he had heard about it from his friends who were here. And so he really wanted to have a program where students from Haiti, from that Catholic school, could also attend Ave Maria at some point in their studies. And once I moved here after the earthquake, we had some contacts at Ave Maria, which we were able to talk to and told us that about the programs that we have here, and that's when I was able to attend. And also my older sister, Gael.
I remember Gael.
Yeah, also attended here.
So this is a family affair.
Right, it's a family affair,
yeah. So the Lissades are royalty on campus.
Yeah, that's true.
And we have with us Hannah Corrao. Hannah's a senior, graduating in what major, Hannah?
Psychology.
In psychology, so you can analyze Junior and me as we go on. Hannah, how did, you know, to come from Madagascar, the Republic of Madagascar,
yes.
How in the world did you end up at Ave Maria?
Well, I would credit it to my grandparents from my father's side, and they told me, and my sister, who was a graduate of Ave, class of 2014, and anyway, they told us about Ave when we were applying for colleges, and they were just really drawn by Ave's mission and the university itself and of it having a Catholic identity, and that's very important in our family, so that's how I heard of Ave.
Fantastic. So you, both of your families have blessed us with two wonderful students. What's it like, you know, to come on a campus in South Florida? What about the diversity on the campus? What's your experience been?
Well, it's a very diverse campus. I love every student is from a different place around the world, is from a different corner of the world. Like you have Hannah from Madagascar. I met her in my freshman year. Mm-hmm. It was actually my first time hearing about Madagascar and knowing people from Madagascar. You have people from all 50 states. You meet people with different experiences, with different, you know, points of view about things. And I think that's what makes it really great, is just the diverse people that you have here and the different stories that you listen to every time.
Has that been your experience, Hannah, coming to Ave Maria?
Yes, for sure. I definitely felt at home right away, meeting Junior and everyone else, my roommates being from different states. So I was definitely able to witness to so many different cultures and even subcultures within their home states and home countries and even from their families, too. So we were able to learn from each other a lot.
You know, that's what makes the Catholic Church so unique, too, is it is universal. Mm-hmm. And it is the Mass in Madagascar and the Mass here at our oratory. Any differences? Any differences in the way the Holy Eucharist is celebrated?
Just the language.
Just the language.
Yeah, but you'll know exactly when we all say the Our Father and, you know, when the priest blesses. I think so, yeah. I would just say the language.
But now,
yeah.
Junior, my wife's been to Haiti, and right. She talks about the Sunday Masses, and she said those are spirit-filled,
yep.
A little different from the yep. toe-tapping that you might see with a hymn mm-hmm. In a Catholic church in America. What's Haitian worship like?
Well, Haitian worship, as you said, very animated, a lot of spirit, a lot of drums, a lot of very loud singing, a lot of hand clapping and dancing, a lot of joy and praising the Lord. So I think that's what makes a difference, is the dancing and the animation that we find back in Haiti. And here people are more, you know, like you said, tapping, going by the measure. But in Haiti, it's very, very animated. It's very spirited. So
yeah. Well, that is the beauty of the church,
right.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
You know, you see Pope Francis, when he does his different travels, mm-hmm. you'll see those differences in the liturgy.
Right.
But the same Jesus in the Eucharist.
Mm-hmm.
Hannah, that, you know, being an international student, being from Madagascar, did you ever feel isolated on the campus or feel like, geez, I've landed on Mars? I mean, to be at Ave Maria?
No, because it helped a lot to have an older sister on campus for the first 2 years,
sure.
at least. And like I said before, I felt right at home. Coming here, and I made so many friends, and I didn't feel like I stuck out at all, and it actually, I really enjoyed sharing my story and where I come from with other people, so that just made it a lot better to, you know, adjust.
Sure. And Junior, I know that a couple years ago you took some Ave Maria University students to Haiti.
Right.
To experience. Talk about that trip and what you did and what was the idea behind the trip.
Correct. So the idea came from my sister and I, who decided, we were like, you know what, we really want to show people where we're from. We always talk about Haiti, always talk about Haitian food, always they're eating Haitian food and whatnot. So we're like, the best way for them to really experience this is by taking them. So we were a little hesitant about asking them, to be honest, because, you know, traveling to a third world country would be difficult, but it was with my roommates, Joe Solorzano and Chris Deslitz, and my sister's roommates who came with us, and we went to Haiti. We did some service work. We also visited the country. My friends absolutely loved it. They always text me and tell me that they want to go back, they want to visit again. And till this day, they still talk about how much of a gratifying experience it was for them to be able to serve the Lord and also, you know, enjoy the country and see what it's really like back there. So I think they love the experience, and I love taking them, and I look forward to, you know, them visiting again and taking a few more people to Haiti, definitely.
Yeah, I know the students that went had an extraordinary time. Yeah. I know my wife did. She was there on that trip with your group, with Gael and everyone. You have such a lovely family. Yeah, I had the opportunity at commencement to meet your family, and you graduate. So who's coming over from Madagascar? Can anyone come? That's a long way.
It is a long way. Unfortunately, no one, at least that I know of, is coming from Madagascar, but my whole family, my parents and my siblings, grandparents will be coming. So
very, very good. And what's next for you?
Well, I plan on moving to Indiana, and it's not so random. My two sisters actually live there right now, and I also have a lot of family from my father's side.
Uh-huh.
So that's a second home for me, and I plan on doing social work after graduating. So.
Social work, and how did you get the idea that that was something you wanted to do?
I felt called to do it. Since high school, I knew that I wanted to major in psychology and I wanted to be able to give back to a community who was more in need and, you know, help, especially young children and families.
What a beautiful calling.
So.
Yeah. And Junior, how about you?
Well, after this, I'm probably moving back to Haiti. My girlfriend Sarah and I have some projects that we want to go back there and help out. Do a lot of social businesses because that's what we believe will definitely help the country, are businesses that will hire people while at the same time being able to create sustainable jobs for people and also create some Haitian products or whatnot. So I think that's what I'll be doing because I love my country, and one of my biggest goals is to one day go back there and help out as much as I can and bring about change. So I think that's what's next for me, is definitely going back to my home country. Yeah.
Beautiful. Just to hear you talk about your plans going forward just tells me you're going to put your faith in action and be the very Catholic leaders that Tom Monahan, our founder, was hoping to produce on our campus. Right. What advice would you give, Junior, to an international student who's thinking of coming to Ave Maria?
Do not be afraid. Do not feel intimidated. Do not feel like you will not belong, because there's a place for everybody at Ave. And I'm not just saying that, and I mean it. It's, you will always find somebody who you'll be able to call your best friend by the end of those 4 years. There's always somebody like Hannah. I met her the first day I got here, and so this day I can call her one of my good friends here. And I think that would be my advice. Do not feel like you won't fit in, because that's what the, you know, like as you said, the Catholic Church is universal. So we all pray the same God, praise Jesus, and that's one of my biggest advice for an
international
student.
And how about you, Hannah? What do you think is the message for a student who's an international student thinking about Ave Maria?
I would definitely draw a lot of what Junior just mentioned, and also I would tell them to definitely be not afraid and show your culture. You know, don't be afraid to be yourself among others, and also it's a whole learning experience. You're coming here to get an education, but also just living here is a whole learning experience itself, so you're going to learn different cultures from your roommates or your classmates, even your professors, the president, and they're going to learn so much from you too, and it'll just be a beautiful time.
Well, I can tell you, as your president, I'm so proud of you both.
Thank
and
you.
You've been a blessing to us, and I think that you've really been a gift to the university, and I think our viewers can appreciate what Ave Maria University has done in your life, but also what you've done for the university. Well, that's the wonder of the university, and these two students embody what I think are Ave Maria University's ideals. Stay with us. We're going to have a brief pause, and we'll be right back with the closing of It's Ave.